can vary to 90% off.
Less.
Uh-huh. So it doesn't make sense. Why are we buying it and making these pharmaceuticals so much wealthier?
Well, definitely the cheaper and generic, cheaper medicine and the generic has its role in putting down the prices of medicine. But not the vaccines. There is still a lot more to be done for vaccines. And in fact, we hope that in the future, we can also have something like that, put a ceiling on vaccines so that
control
we can
control it once and for all.
We can, well, not really control, but try to put in some kind of leverage to put more vaccine resources into our even doctors to make them see that more people will be benefited if the prices are down. See, vaccines are not vaccines are given free in the local centers, right? Mm-hmm. But not the new vaccines. Mm-hmm. The new vaccines that I'm talking about, like rotavirus, is only available in the private sector. And admittedly, not everybody has that kind of advocacy and has not that kind of
Knowledge, of education to begin with.
Well, yeah. some physicians might put the prices higher than others. Not all physicians will make vaccines affordable. Even if the companies, I'm sure there are companies now who try to put vaccination prices down, but because it is in the private sector, it's the doctors who give the vaccines.
Dependence
on also, yes, there's also
should they promote it? The problem
way
is they may
of,
not.
Of getting, and I have heard this from my dealings with people and with public, that they say, ang taas-taas naman ho ng bakuna ninyo, no? Bakit ho ba ganyan? Binayaran namin ng 6,000 yung isa. When I know that vaccine could have been given for even 1,000, but some would get it for 6, others would get it for 5. You know, because it's in the private sector, and we know how varied the medical centers are. You know,
hindi regulated kasi.
That's right. Going to a big center compared to a medical clinic in the community will have different kinds of price range.
So we have to go by way of legislation, and we have to be able to afford it. That's what you're saying. There's no middle of the road.
Yes.
And there is no procrastination. We can't afford to wait out.
And there's also a possibility that our government can lead the way to have a vaccine fund, just like what they did in Latin America. You know, we're far behind from Latin America when it comes to vaccine funds. In Latin America, since more than 20 years ago,
Whose fault is that we are behind a Latin American country? Is it the legislators? Is it the medical profession? Businessmen?
I don't think it's anybody's fault. It's just that there are champions for vaccines. Mm. In Latin America, I'll tell you, there is somebody there from PAHO, from the Pan American Health Association. In fact, he has been decorated many times. He's now the executive director of the Albert Sabin Vaccine Institute based in Washington. He was a champion for that. He did this kind of vaccine advocacy. He gelled together. He collaborated with many country managers, program managers, to really come up and put vaccination at the forefront of child health. So they realized early on the value of vaccination. They talk about vaccination. They put vaccination and made sure that policymakers understand what it means. And it has really done its rewards now. You can see Latin America has most of these new vaccines in their immunization program. Rotavirus, pneumococcal conjugate vaccines, because they realize the value of this, just like America. And their infant mortality rate, their health status,
has reduced dramatically, bringing down their health cost at the end of the day. Because it's ridiculous. Babaliktad. Let's not be reactionary. Let's be proactive.
We need champions to make
Well, that's
sure.
why you're here, Doctora.
Well,
that's why you're here
like
on TV,
to, I'd like
which is
to
why
think
it's very
that
important.
We can start. We are not too far behind. But if we do our part in terms of trying to make people understand, just like, you know, I thank you for this opportunity to be here, because this is, in fact, what we need to let our government and our people hear it. In Australia,
are you succeeding with legislation? Do you feel you're succeeding?
Well, I'll tell you what. I was so happy when Secretary Duque in 2006 made the administrative order to put hepatitis B vaccination at birth.
At birth now.
At birth. You know, we have not improved our hepatitis B carrier rate because we started doing it at 6 weeks, when in fact we have a very high transmission from mother to baby. And it can only be controlled and it can only be stopped
the minute
by putting hepatitis B vaccination at birth. Thailand and Taiwan did that in 1990. As far as we know, there was no effort to put that similarly to like Thailand and Taiwan did. You know, Taiwan, I was just in Taiwan last week, and they have shown a remarkable reduction, 99%
is that
loss of hepatitis B carrier. Ours
responsibilidad ba yan ng health secretary or kailangan sa legislatura? Sa health secretary, sa executive group na yan?
Yes. Health secretaries always think, you know, what the people would need. But then, who gives them the budget?
Back
it's the legislature.
I
tell you, they can make life miserable for the health secretary by just saying, I'll give you a zero, one peso.
Doctora, we've reached the end of the program. It's so quick to sit with you and learn of these issues. But I'd like to give you the last three minutes or so to be able to address our viewers directly. Speak on the camera as like you would a senator and a congressman so that they will move as an exit message, that camera.
Oh, thank you, Harry. You know, my last opinion and messages would be about preventing early childhood diarrhea. I look at this and you will see that early childhood diarrhea can affect our people. They can reduce growth. They can reduce IQ. They can actually be reduced in terms of physical fitness. This diarrhea is not to be taken for granted. And if we can prevent them, see, it's not just death that we would like to prevent. We would like to prevent as much as possible growth reduction or malnutrition. We want to prevent as much as possible the disabilities that come with illnesses. So we hope that we could address these issues, put more vaccination into our national immunization program, gather our health policymakers, our even local politicians, to really consider looking at the value of vaccination, making health and vaccine an investment, because it is an investment that could produce good outputs and better health for everyone. It is a right of every child and every person to be given that kind of health.
Thank you very much, Doctora. Bravo. Ladies and gentlemen, what was brought to you is not just an advocacy, but maybe the key words is health economics, political will. Can we afford to wait on it? Can we even afford the vaccine? The answer there, you already know. So what's your role in watching this? I guess first to understand, because it can happen to you. Alam mo naman, lahat tayo naman, maski papano, no? When we have the kids, diarrhea, don't take it too lightly. I hope you've learned as much as I have in this program. I'm sitting in on behalf of Annette Ablan, who will be back in about another week, 2 weeks. So I'll be sitting in again in her next program. That will be next Thursday night. Maraming salamat po. Thank you very much, Doctora.
Thank you.